Hello everyone, my name is Greg and I dev stuff. Welcome everyone to episode 1 of Stardew Valley-like game in Unity. Welcome once again to our new series. In this series I will be covering creation of the games like Stardew Valley or Rune Factory. Yeah, I'm that kind of boomer who still remembers this series. We will be covering most of the gameplay features in those games like farming, building, crafting, combat, etc, etc. Today we will start very small. We will create our character, animate him, and make the basic camera following him around. Let's begin by implementing basic movement of the character in 2D environment. Of course, if you want, you can change the environment to be 3D, but it is up to you, and you will have to adjust all the necessary changes. But besides that, the rest of the tutorial should work perfectly fine with any kind of environment. Just as I said above, you just should change every context-specific call, like an colliders or raycast, to use 3D1 instead of 2D1. After creating a new project using 2D preset in Unity, very first thing I downloaded a free sprite sheets of the character and overworld tile set from the opengameart.org. The links will be in the description to download those assets. Please visit those artists and say that they are awesome, because free art is awesome and so are artists who make it. Good, let's start by creating and animating the character. To do that, first we need to slice our character sprite sheet into frames of animation. Select the character sprite sheet, change its sprite mode to multiple, and open sprite editor. Inside, click on slice, and select grid by cell count. Now input the row and column count, and press slice. Good. Press apply and close the window. Next, we want to create the character on the screen. We can build our character ourselves. Like create a sprite object, then attach animator. Then create and assign the animator controller. But we can make a small shortcut by using a first type of walk cycle and drag and dropping it on the scene. So like walk cycle in this art sheet is comprised of 8 sprites. So select first 8 sprites and drag and drop them on the scene. The window prompt will appear and ask you to assign a new name to the animation and where to save it. Let's call it main character walk animation down. And save it inside sprite animation clips. If you do it this way, Unity will create an object with sprite renderer and animator already attached. Besides that, it automatically created an animator controller. Let's move this animator controller to a separate folder called animator controller. Good. Now if we launch the game, we will see our small character doing like a little walk dance. But he's not moving at all. So now we want to give him some kind of motion. Select the character in the hierarchy. Let's rename him from whatever this name is. Actually, this is the name of the first frame of animation. Into the main character. Then create and add a new script called CharacterController2D. Open the newly created script. Good. Inside we want to create a simple description of character controls. First, let's add the attribute called requireComponent with type of rigidbody2D to make sure that if you later on will add this character controller to any other object, it will automatically add the rigidbody2D or will throw a warning. Let's cache the reference to the rigidbody2D on the awake. Now define serialized variable speed of type float. And now in the fixed update, create and call the new method called move. To move character, we want to update character velocity on fixed update. To do that, declare vector2 called motionVector. In update, assign the value s to the motionVector based on the horizontal and vertical axis input. And then assign motion vector to the rigid body velocity. Let's test this. Make the gravity scale equals to 0, because our game is top down and doesn't need gravity in this kind of environment. Good, now you can see that our camera stays in place and doesn't move around after character moves. So, how can we fix this? Let's use Cine Machine camera. Cine Machine is actually the part of Unity which is not included into the project by default. Open the package manager and add the Cine Machine into your project. After it is done installing, you can notice that we have a new option at the top menu called Cine Machine. If you click it, you will see selection of many cameras to choose from. But we just need a 2D camera. So click on the 2D camera. This will create what is called a virtual camera. Virtual camera is supplement system to your camera. It will lead your camera to look at specific character and track it around based on its settings. This is important to understand that virtual cameras is a supplemental tool. Your camera is still in the world and still being used by the renderer. The virtual cameras are just guiding tools, which will help your camera to understand where it needs to be and what it needs to look at with which settings. So we want to follow our character around. To make Sim Machine to follow your character around, you need to assign the character into follow property on your virtual camera. If you launch the game now, it will look too far zoomed out. To fix this, change the orthographic size on your virtual camera. Then if you again launch the game, you might notice that your character feels jittery after it moves. It is because we are trying to track the object, which is not being interpolated between frames. Physics engine in Unity runs on fixed time delta. That means it runs on internal fixed timer. While renderer runs on time delta, which represents the time between current and last frame rendered. The difference in timing causes conflict, and this conflict causes jittering effect. To deal with it, we are using interpolation. Interpolation does pretty much projection of the physical object between physical frames. So if you have 3 rendered frames between 2 physical frames, the rigid body will make sure to interpolate your object sprite to sync it with the renderer. Good. So camera follow our character, and it makes it with a little dumping, simulating this effect like it trying to catch up with your character. Now there is another issue. You see, your character looks like he's extremely blurry for no reason. To fix this, select his sprite sheet. In the matter of fact, no, select all sprite sheets. And select filter mode to be point, no filter. Set compression to none. And set pixel per unit to 32. We want to make our character rotate towards the vector of movement. So if you walk left, he will rotate and look left. If he walk right, he will rotate and look right. To do that, select the main character and open animator window. Inside, create a new blend tree. And change the type of the blend tree to 2D simple directional. Add 2 float parameters for horizontal and vertical motion. So we will be able to tell our animator controller our movement direction. Now let's create the last 3 directional movement animations. So select for 8 frames of the directional movement and drag and drop them on the character. Open blend tree and inside add 4 motion fields. then place them in four cardinal directions to represent up, down, and left-right movement. Then assign appropriate animation to those fields. Make the movement node as the default node for the animator. Now inside the character controller 2D we will cache the reference to the animator. And assign the horizontal and vertical parameters in the animator. Good, we don't have an appropriate idle animation yet. I will look into making one until next episode. Good, this is it for this episode. If you have any questions or any ideas about code, please leave your comment below. If you're interested in seeing what will come out of this, please subscribe. If you want to support further, you can find my Patreon in the description. With best regards, see you in the next episode.